In this video, you're going to learn how to set up the recommended metrics and columns for your Google Shopping campaign. We need to do this before we can optimize our Google Shopping campaign so that we can see the metrics that matter right there in our account. Google doesn't show these metrics by default and we need to unhide them. So we're going to add these as custom columns so you can see them for your campaigns, your ad groups, your product groups, and everywhere else in your account. I'll also teach you how to set up custom columns in your account. This allows you to add formulas to play with the metrics and show you exactly how much profit your campaign has generated. To do this, open up your Google Ads account by going to ads.google.com. Make sure you're at the campaign level by going to All Campaigns and then Campaigns on the left-hand menu. Click Columns. Click Modify Columns. Now we can see all the custom column selectors and modify what our columns look like. Let's remove all the current columns already by clicking the X symbols for these metrics on the right. Also, deselect this option here, Show Recommended Columns in Your Tables. Click, turn it off. Now that we are starting from scratch, we can choose the right metrics and have them in the right order. Follow what I do and add in these metrics here to use the same setup that I like to use when using Google Ads for e-commerce. Click on Performance. Now we'll click in this exact order. Impressions, clicks, CTR, average CPC, and cost. So now the metrics on the right should look like this. Got it? Okay, let's keep going. Close Performance and open up Conversions. Now we'll click Conversions, Conversion Value, Conversion Rate, Cost Per Conversions, Conversion Value Divided by Cost. Now your metrics on the right hand side should look like this. Okay, let's now close Conversions and open up Competitive Metrics. Let's now click Search Impression Share, Search Lost IS Rank, and Search Lost IS Budget. You can now close Competitive Metrics. Now double check the metrics on the right and they should list out in this order. If you couldn't find some metrics there, it's probably because you're not looking at your campaigns on the campaign level. You might be seeing them on the product level, keyword level, but not at the campaign level. If this is happening, just click Cancel to get out of the column setup, click All Campaigns on the left, and click Campaigns, Campaigns. If you didn't have any problems, then just click Apply. Now you should see the columns here for your campaigns and view all these metrics. Awesome. The next thing we want to do is show what are called custom columns. These are columns that allow us to use formulas to manipulate the data and get some really useful insights into our campaigns. For example, we'll be able to see how much profit each campaign has generated and even how much profit per conversion. Let's do this right now. Again, click Columns and Modify Columns. Now scroll all the way down to the bottom and click Plus Custom Column. Let's name this one Profit Generated. Click in this box and we'll now build out our formula. Follow what I do and then I'll explain later. Add in an open bracket, then click the plus column, click Conversions, and scroll down to find Conversion Value. Add the multiply symbol. Then we want to add in, as a decimal point, your net profit margin percentage. If you don't know this exact figure, that's okay, just add an estimate for now. It's usually between 10 to 50% depending on your store. I have a full lesson that shows you how to calculate this yourself, so I'll leave that in a link below. For now, just add in an estimate so we can set up our columns. For this store, they have a 50% profit margin, so I'll write that as 0.5. Add a closed bracket. Now add in the subtraction symbol. Now we want to click plus column again and click performance and select cost. Now your formula should look like this. Double check to make sure it does, but with your own profit margin percentage here as a decimal. Click save. Now that we've added in our profit generated, let's now add in average profit per conversion. This metric will tell us, on average, how much profit we make per sale through Google Ads on our e-commerce store. Let's repeat this process, but with a slightly different formula. Click plus custom column, add the name average profit per conversion, click the formula creation box. Let's now make two open brackets, click plus column, and we'll repeat what we did in the last formula. Click conversions and scroll down to find conversion value. Add the multiply symbol. Now add in our net profit margin as a decimal, same as before. Add a closing bracket, add the subtraction symbol, click the plus column again and click performance and select cost. Now let's add a closing bracket, then add in a divide symbol. Now go to plus column and click conversions and find conversions. Your formula should now look like this, but with your own profit margin added as a decimal. This formula calculates the total net profit for a campaign and then divides that by the number of conversions that campaign has achieved. In other words, the average profit per conversion, or average profit you generate from each order from this campaign. Pretty cool, huh? Let's now click save. On your list of metrics on the right here, scroll down and make sure that you have profit generated and average profit per conversion at the bottom. If not, just click custom columns and select them. Okay, let's now make sure we can see these in our campaign. Click apply. Now if we scroll all the way to the very right hand side, you should now see profit generated and average profit per conversion there. Some really interesting and useful metrics for our campaign. Now, it's taken some work to set these up. How about we save them as a save template so we don't have to repeat this process all over again? Click columns, modify columns, click save column set, and add in a name like campaign columns. Click save and apply, and now we're saved. Now, we just did this at the campaign level of our account. When you go down to other levels like ad groups or keyword levels, you'll need to enable the custom columns there too. This is because there are different metrics shown to you on each level of your account. Okay, now we know how to set up recommended columns for our Google Shopping campaign. If you want to learn more about the metrics, what they mean, and how you can use them, we have a full video guide going into each metric. I'll leave a link to that guide down below. Now, if you're watching this video on YouTube, it's actually part of our free Google Shopping course. It's 100% free with no sign up required on our website. It shows you everything you need to set up, optimize, and scale your Google Shopping campaigns. I'll leave a link down below. If this video was helpful, guys, please hit the like button. Let me know in the comments below. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.